Hello, and welcome to Denmark. The mood is dark around Elsinore Castle. Recently, Hamlet has contended with the death of his father and the fact that his mother has been married to his father's brother, Hamlet's uncle. Hamlet has become deeply upset and cruel grim events as they unfold.
As Hamlet can watch with his friend Horatio on the battlements of Elsinore Castle, his father's ghost appeared to him and told him how Claudius had murdered him.
This was always in the ever by your father was the vengeance foul most unnatural
murder
most fire. To give life as living in mine orchard, a serpent stung me, but no thou no beast. The serpent that this thing thy father like now wears his crown.
Oh my prophetic soul, my uncle? Claudius and Gertrude are getting prepared for their evening. Hamlet comes in and they quarrel because of Hamlet's depressed behavior.
But now my cousin Hamlet and my son, how is it that the clouds come hang on you?
Good Hamlet, cast thy knightish color off, and let thine eye look like a friend of Denmark. Do not forever with thy veiled lid seek for thy noble father in the dust. Thou knowest his common, all that lives must die, passing through nature to eternity.
Oh, that this tutu solid flesh would melt, thaw and resolve itself into a new. Oh, that this everlasting hand not fix his candy so strong. Oh, God, God, how weary, stale, flat, and unprofitable seem to me all the uses of this world. Hamlet kept the ghost revelation a secret, but all the court noticed how unstable Hamlet had become. Even Ophelia had to suffer from Hamlet's feelings as they fluctuated between tenderness and scorn.
I did love you once.
Indeed, my lord, you made me believe so.
You should not have believed me. I loved you once.
I was the more deceived.
If thou dost marry, I'll give you this plain for thy dowry. Be thou as chaste as ice, as pure as snow. Get thee to a nunnery. Farewell.
And I, a ways most deject and wretched, that suck the honey of his music vows, now see that noble and most silent visit, like sweet bell jails, tired and harsh. Oh, woe is me to see what I see. See what I see.
Unable to trust anyone at court, Hamlet felt miserable and confused. Should he take his own advice for that of his father murdered Claudius?
To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take up arms against the sea of troubles by opposing infamy. To die to sleep, no more by a sleep to save the end, the heartache and the thousand natural shocks that flesh is heir to, 'tis consummation devoutly to be wished.
In the arrival of an acting troupe gave Hamlet an idea of how to unmask King Claudius. We'll get them to reenact this ghost version of the murder and see how Claudius reacts to the clip.
I'll have these players play something like the murder of my father before my uncle. I'll observe his looks and I'll tempt him to the quick, but if he do blench, I'll know my course. The play's a thing where I'll catch the conscience of the king.
Before the assembled court, the actors on Hamlet's orders put on a play, mimicking the stories. Claudius was so shocked by the murder scene, he rushed out from the room. Hamlet no longer doubted his uncle's guilt.
With the Cates band thrice blasted, thrice infected, now natural and magic can die properly, on wholesome life you serve immediately.
Give me some run away!
Claudius and Laertes plot to kill Hamlet and make his death like an accident. They will tip Hamlet to a sword by Laertes will use a poisoned sword instead of a blunted pole.
Claudius also prepared a cup of poison drink in case of Laertes failed to kill him. Instead, will set to dispose of Hamlet.
I will, my lord. I pray you pardon me.
Here's the poison cup. It is too late.
My lord, I'll hit him now.
Come for the third layer, tease. You do but dally. I pray you pass me with your best violence.
Say you so. Come on. Have at you now.
Nay, come again.
While the fight was happening, Laertes dropped his poison sword as Hamlet drops his, and they each pick up the other's sword.
Hamlet died slain. No medicine in the world can do him good. Indeed, there's not even half an hour of life. The treacherous instrument is in thy hand, unbated and invisible.
But yet, the fin of my friends, but I am but hurt.
Drink off this potion. Is thy union here? Follow my mother!
The potent poison quite o'egrows my spirit. I cannot live to hear the news from England, but I do prophesy the election lights on Fortinbras. He hath my dying voice. The rest is silence.
Now cracks a noble heart. Good night, sweet prince, and flights of angels sing thee to thy rest.
Resurrect.
Thank you.